guys. Welcome back to Marywood After Dark. I'm Erin Kane.
And I'm Ashlyn Jess. As you can see, we are in a little bit of a change of scenery, and that is because Erin and I both did not get guests for this week. So for the next 5 to 10 minutes, because we are doing a shorter episode today, you're going to be stuck with the two of us.
Sorry. Hopefully this is enjoyable for you all.
I mean, it's short and sweet and to the point, so yes. I don't see why it wouldn't be.
Yes. So we are actually going to go around campus and ask Marywood students random questions, because why not?
I'm a random person. I got a random mind. We're going to work with it and see what happens. Stay tuned, guys. Are you ready?
Excuse me, ma'am? Ma'am. Hi, guys. Would you like to be a part of our show?
Yes,
sir. Excuse me, sir?
Excuse me. Would you like to be
Can
in our
be
show?
Can you be on our show? Here, let's get over here.
Excuse me. Would you like to be on our TV show?
Not scripted at
cool.
all.
Cool. Come on over. Oh, wait. We got another guest.
I mean, I have a meeting in 10 minutes.
Great. We only need two.
Okay, great.
So would you like to be on our show?
Sure.
Okay. Awesome. Thanks, Matt.
Hello.
Hi. My name's Erin. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Great. I am the host, along with Ashlyn, on our TV show called Marywood After Dark.
Okay.
How does that make you feel?
Good. Great.
So, first off, what are your names?
Alyssa.
Cassandra.
Nice right, to meet cool. you, Alyssa and Cassandra.
Cool. I'm Erin.
How are you? What's your name?
Connor Reed.
That's nice. I'm Erin. Okay, so what's your name?
Michael.
Okay, nice to meet you, Mike. I'm Erin.
I'm Matt Gist.
All right, I just wanted to confirm that that was actually your name.
I'm Erin.
Hi, I'm Annie.
I'm
nice
a host.
You. I'm Ashlyn.
Hi.
Nice to ask you to join.
What's your name?
Emily.
Cool, welcome to Marywood After Dark, everybody. All right, so the first question is, if you had to replace milk with any other beverage when you're eating cereal, what would you choose?
Almond milk.
It can't
be milk,
Cassandra.
It has to be in the cereal.
Are you vegan?
In the cereal.
I'm lactose intolerant.
It has to be in the cereal. So like orange juice or apple juice, something like that.
I put water in my cereal.
Probably water.
No way. No way. Okay, I have a question. This is one of my favorite would you rather questions. Okay. Would you rather have extremely large feet, like clown feet, or extremely large hands?
Probably feet. They're less noticeable.
Extremely large feet.
Large hands, because I could pick up more stuff.
You know what? I was thinking the same thing. Large hands is a very good quality to have.
I'm pretty impressed with that. Okay. All right. Next question. If you could make anything an Olympic sport that you guys would win the gold medal at, what would you pick?
Sleeping.
Taking a selfie.
Did you ever hear the song, Can I Take a Selfie?
By the... Or is it by the
Actually, I think it's actually called hashtag selfie.
And I think it's by the Chainsmokers.
No way.
Alyssa specializes in selfie taking. Yeah.
I can tell that you are a very quality selfie taker just by the look of you. That you look like... You look like you take great selfies.
A Snapchat selfie.
Would you rather live... Okay, here we go.
Listen up, guys.
All right, here we go. Would you rather live alone for the rest of your life or be surrounded by extremely annoying people for the rest of your life?
Alone.
I hate annoying people.
Probably alone, too.
Alone?
How many annoying people?
At least 5, but I would have to say 50.
It's like living with us.
I can't do it.
All right, now, last question. What do you guys think is the stereotype about your major? So our major is comm arts or digital media. The stereotype about our major is that our major is the easiest.
Too easy.
What do
this
you guys?
This is not easy, guys.
What do you guys think?
Nerds.
What's your major?
Speech language pathology.
Pre PA.
Did you not know your major?
I do, but I'm thinking of a thing to say. just study too much, I guess.
Okay. How about you?
Nutrition, dietetics, health freaks, I guess.
Okay. That was awesome.
All right, cool. So that was our first segment of guests, everybody. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Let's go find our next people to interview. Let's get it.
What's your major here at Marywood?
Computer science.
Ooh, yeah. Why wouldn't they be on?
Yeah, no, they're not on. We're just talking to nothing right now.
Okay.
Just kidding.
All right, so I have a question.
Rude. I'm kidding.
What is the most annoying thing anybody has ever asked you?
Please don't say it was to be a part of the show.
Yeah, I was going to say that, but I didn't want to be mean. I don't know. This is so hard. You're putting me under a lot
of
pressure.
Okay, that's fine. I have a would you rather.
We'll get the next question.
We got this.
I'm more of that kind
of guy. Would you rather lose your left hand or right foot?
Definitely right foot.
Why?
Because I kick with my left foot and I write with my left hand.
But you can't kick if you only have one foot.
No, you can.
You definitely can.
You have to hop into it. You kind of go like...
I could just put my, little stub in the dirt and kick it.
You didn't say you would get a stub.
What else would you have if you didn't have a foot?
All right, next question. Next question. What do you think you would win in the Olympics?
Definitely a gold medal.
Good answer.
In what?
We like that answer.
In what?
Curling.
Curling. Oh, that's interesting.
You were a beast at curling.
Okay, Eva, would you rather? Would you rather eat a box of dry spaghetti or a cup of uncooked noodles?
They're definitely the same thing. You can't fool me on that.
I lied because I read the question wrong. It's actually a cup of uncooked rice.
I would probably eat the noodles.
Oh, okay, cool.
I think I'd pick the noodles, too. I think that's a good question.
That's a normal thing.
Yeah.
All right, so I have one more question, and then we'll ask our final question. So, basically, my next question is, do you put ice cubes in your cereal to keep your cereal cold?
Yeah, sometimes.
Me, too.
Yeah, it's kind perfect. Of nuts.
I'm surrounded by lunatics.
It's perfect.
Yeah,
it keeps your cereal very cold. So, why don't you ask about your major?
All right, so now we have a question about your major. What do you think is the stereotype about your major? Like, what does everybody think
about your major? Like, everyone thinks our major, which is comm arts,
a bunch of dorks.
Bunch of
but
dorks?
We're not. We're cool people.
Okay.
Yeah, all
you
right.
Seem like a cool guy.
Nice guys.
That's what I like to hear. Thank you so much,
if you
Connor.
Win the oh, gold medal, don't forget about me.
Exactly. You can't forget about a TV show. We gave you your start.
Yeah, make sure you share it when you become like, okay.
I'll share it, yeah.
All right, cool. Awesome. Thank you, Connor,
right,
host of the TV Marywood After Dark.
This is really funny,
I almost
though.
Said our show wrong.
This is really funny because Michael's a part of our TV show. He's behind the scenes. Yeah. We love it.
So what's your position on our show, Michael?
I am a teleprompter.
Okay, and how do you enjoy that position?
I really enjoy it.
Oh, good. Awesome. Thank you for lying for us. Just kidding.
Okay.
No, do you really enjoy it?
Yeah, I do.
Okay,
all
right.
Yeah.
I'm kidding.
I like to think Erin and I are fun people to work with, but I mean, I also could just be conceited and think I'm really great. So
yeah,
you never know.
Yeah, that's why I said that. Okay.
All right, I got a question. Let me start us off. So, what is the most impressive thing that you think you know how to do?
I think that I can juggle, but like in reality, I can't.
Ooh.
Oh, I like the honesty. I can rock with that.
Okay, I have a would you rather. I like would you rather, so I like to ask those quiet questions. Would you rather find $5 on the ground or find all of your missing socks?
$5, because like you can save that up.
But would you save it?
Huh?
Would you actually save the $5?
Yes, I would.
Oh, okay, good for you. Me, not so much.
No, I was about to say, I'd spend that right away.
Socks?
Mom and Dad, you know exactly
but,
what
like,
I'm talking about.
If you use the $5 to like put it into like a checking account or something like that, you can use that to pay off student loans and stuff like that. So like, you know, it do be like that sometimes.
Yeah,
my
you're
mind
right.
Is really blown right now. I did not think into it.
Honestly, if it was me, I would try to find all my missing socks. I never have a matching sock on, ever.
You see, I just wear fun socks a lot, so I just rock with that. But anyway.
Or you could just completely purge on anything that you buy on Amazon.
Oh.
Okay, here we go. I have another question. Would you rather? Would you rather get $5 for every song you sang in public or $50 for every stranger you kiss?
I would do $5 every time I sing because, like, you know, I sing a lot. Like, you know, I got my headphones in and I'm, like, singing along to, like, every song that I have that I'm playing on Spotify and stuff like that. So, you know, it just...
It would add up.
Yeah, it would add up.
Okay. But you get $50 for kissing a stranger.
Yeah, but you don't know what that stranger's got going on in their mouth.
Take it?
Or
that would
like
be
what's happening.
I am single, by the way, so like if anybody wants to come at me, like I'm here.
Okay. Perfect. This is turning into a dating show.
Oh
yes,
my
I love that.
Goodness.
All right, now I have single if anyone. No.
Okay. All right, I got one last question for you. All right. So, if you could be a famous author or a famous movie director, which one would you pick and why?
I would go with famous director because, like, I really enjoy, like, a lot of film, like, Wes Anderson and all that stuff, like Tim Burton. I really enjoy that kind of stuff.
Nice. Cool. Did you all enjoy right. yourself on our show?
Yes, I do.
You heard it awesome. Here, guys. If Mike ever makes it big, he made it big because of TV Marywood and Marywood After Dark.
Yes. All right, let's find our next person. Let's go. First off, can you sing the Greasy Spoon song by SpongeBob?
No, I'm good.
How about Bye, Buddy? Hope you find your dad by the L.
There's too many people watching for this.
Okay, then I'm just going to go on with asking questions then, okay?
Would you rather have extremely large feet, extremely large hands, or extremely large ears?
Probably feet.
Why?
I don't know, I feel like big feet would be cool.
Would you?
Yeah.
What if you? That would be a lot of toe stubbing, though.
Yeah, probably.
You'd stub your toe everywhere you went.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
You get used to it, though.
All right. Would you, Would you rather never be stuck in traffic again, or never get another cold?
Never get another cold.
Really? You like traffic?
It doesn't bother me. I'm used to it.
Oh, okay.
I travel 81 every day.
All right.
Oh, that's true. Matt is a commuter here at Marywood University.
How is the commuter life?
It's not bad. I don't mind it.
If you could eat one food for the rest of your life, what would you pick?
Chicken Alfredo.
Ooh, from where? Anywhere? Right.
Olive Garden.
Really? Olive Garden. My mom's a big fan of Olive Garden. Shout out to my mom.
Shout out, Mrs. Kane.
Thank you, Matt. Okay, I don't know, man. Thank you for your interview, bro. You are really the best interviewer this whole time.
Anytime.
I say a lot. It was really, really impressive.
I do good.
Yeah, you did really good. This has been the best interview, I think, of all of TV Marywood.
Thanks.
Annie, nice to meet you, Annie. Are you a part of the Marywood softball team?
No, yeah. She just likes to wear that stuff for fun.
Never worn another sports outfit before?
I've worn sports outfits, sports that I've played.
Whatever. Okay, so tell me about yourself. So what position do you play on the softball team?
I'm a catcher.
Oh, that is amazing. Do you want to know why?
Why?
Because I played softball in high school. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And I was a catcher for a little bit.
Yes! Best position!
Yes, it is. It really was so much fun.
Oh, yeah.
There's a reason I don't play anymore, but it was fun.
Do you know Megan Gabe?
I do know Megan Gabe. I love Megan Gabe.
Oh my God, I love Megan Gabe too. Megan Gabe lives around the corner from me in Logren Hall, just so everybody gets a clear perspective of what's happening.
Yes. So I'm going
to... Megan was actually my recruit when she came to visit Marywood.
I love making friends. This is awesome.
And me and her are the two catchers.
We're really bonding over here.
That's awesome.
I know. Can we be friends?
Of course.
Okay, good.
Oh, we love making new friendships here on Marywood After
Dark. Okay, so I'm going to ask you our first would-you-rather question.
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, so would you rather have a bottomless box of Legos or a bottomless gas tank? Legos. Or gas tank.
Gotta be Legos. You can never have enough Legos, and I feel like those could always come in handy if you want to, play Legos with someone, you know?
But it's gas. You have...
Gas for your car? You need to be a little more specific with that one.
Because
I was thinking a bottomless thing of carbon dioxide. I didn't really know what was happening.
I was oxygen, I got enough of that in the air.
Do we have enough oxygen in the air, though? Do we?
No, we do not.
I don't know the actual answer to that question, but...
All right, I'm going to ask you another would-you-rather question. We're just shooting for the stars here.
I love how I made a new friend. Okay, go ahead.
All right, would you rather have the color eyes you have now or be able to pick any other color of the rainbow?
I would love to have purple eyes.
That's a good question.
No one has purple eyes.
That's so sick. I was literally thinking she read my mind.
What are you working on right here?
Hi, I'm working on a project for my nutrition education class. It's called Honoring God with Your Body. I'm presenting it to Delight a few Thursday nights from now. Shameless self-promo. I think April 11th also come to Delight. Also, and we're just going to talk about whole grains and mindful eating and why God loves you and loves your body and why you should love your body and honor it in that way.
Are you a vegan?
No.
Okay. Awesome. So, what's a stereotype about your major?
Oh, I'm so ready. Probably my biggest one is that people call us nutritionists, and that sort of kills us because we're working to be a dietitian. To be a dietitian, you have to have 4 years of schooling, 1,200 hours of internship. You need the practice, and you need to pass the board's exam to be a dietitian. Anyone could label themselves nutritionists, and so it kills me. I literally have a science teacher who'd be like, I know all of you are studying to be nutritionists. I'm like, and it hurts my heart just a little bit. I literally wear a necklace. Ready? Okay. And it says RDN on it. The D is actually the National Eating Disorder Awareness Symbol, which is why I want to be a dietitian, because I have a past in that. And then RDN is my future. And so it's very much a term that means something, and nutritionist doesn't mean anything.
That's so cool. That's so motivational.
Guys, very awesome.
Everybody needs to keep up with Andy over here. We're rocking it.
That was a great turn of events on our show right now. That's great.
Exactly.
Yes.
Love this.
Marywood bringing people together.
Yes.
Oh,
all right. So thank you.
Thank you so much for being on the show. Would you rather go to Antarctica for a year or be stuck in jail for a year?
Probably stuck in jail, just because I don't do cold very well. So
I respect that.
I'd rather be in a nice warm jail.
But is jail warm? I don't know.
I mean,
I feel like it is. I feel like.
I mean, there's a lot of bodies in there, so.
Yeah, a lot of bodies in one room.
Which is unfortunate.
Yeah.
Anyways, I have a would you rather. I like would you rathers. Do you like would you rathers?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I hope you said yes because I was asking you them whether you liked them or not. So, all right. Erin can't talk today either. Would you rather your only mode of transportation be a donkey or a giraffe?
A giraffe.
Me too.
Yeah, that's so cool.
Did you
giraffes.
See that new giraffe that was just born?
The baby? Yeah. So cute. Cool. So cute.
I feel so out of the loop. I didn't see the giraffe. I'll look it up later. It's fine.
Everywhere, Ashlyn.
Apparently not. Listen, I woke up at 10:30 today and I was just rolling with it.
It happened like 3 days ago.
Irrelevant. All right. Cool.
All right. Sorry.
Sorry. I just like touched part of it. Okay. So, would you rather be a nursing major or a pre-PA major?
Well, I am a nursing major, so I'm going to have to go with nursing. I did research both before I came here, and I just feel like with what I want to do, like my end goal for my career, I think the nursing path is just the way for me to go. Some people, it's pre-PA, but I think the nursing path for me is going to take me farther than pre-PA.
That's what I like to hear. She's a self-motivated gal over here.
That's awesome. It's just so hard for me to ask, like, serious questions right now.
Then ask funny ones.
Okay. I'm going to ask funny ones then. All right. So, basically, would you rather live in a cave or live in a treehouse?
A treehouse.
I agree. What was your favorite show on Nickelodeon?
Nickelodeon? Probably iCarly.
Oh, okay. How'd you feel about Drake and Josh?
I love that show, too.
Remember when they got stuck in the treehouse?
Yes. I do.
Everything always comes full circle with Erin. It just, like, no matter how long it takes, it always gets
back. That should have been my first thought.
I'm amazed. What is that word? What's that word? Proskauer.
Yeah, that's a name. Like, that's the name of the guy who invented
it. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. Well, we're going to find our next person. So now, while Ashlyn looks at questions, I'm going to grab my good friend Emily over here and interview her.
What is the funniest name you have heard in the real world?
Funniest name I've ever heard in the real world.
If I'm being honest, it's just not a funny name, but the most interesting name is definitely Nicolo. He's our station manager, also my boyfriend. But
Ellen, like, I know a celebrity named their child Apple. I don't know if I would ever name a child Apple.
Apple.
Yeah.
Someone who named their kid Northwest or something.
That was Kanye.
Isn't that Kanye?
Yeah. Kanye's weird.
What's it called? My boyfriend calls his brother's girlfriend a Memzibeth.
Oh, never heard of that one before.
It's not her name. It's just they call her that just because I'm not really sure.
That's fun.
Hey, Jason.
All right, so first off, what was your favorite TV show growing up?
My favorite TV show growing up was probably Wizards of Waverly Place.
Really?
Oh, what a banger. I always forget about that show.
Yeah, you know, and like Drake and Josh and iCarly, those were good bops.
I'm going to be honest with you. I was never really into Wizards.
I love Wizards.
Really?
I love Wizards, vampires, and, like, werewolves. Like, those are,
exactly.
Like,
that was everything in that show, too, because you had Greg Sulkin come in as a werewolf, right? And then David Henry's girlfriend in that one episode was played by Bridget Mendler, was a vampire. I can't believe I remember all this. Everything's hitting me.
Have you ever seen Sabrina the Teenage Witch?
Yes, I have. I like that show,
That was cool.
I love
Isn't she pregnant or something?
I don't know. She might. Are you thinking of Zoe 101?
Yeah, Zoe 101, she was
pregnant. There was a show. There was a show, I swear, and the girl was pregnant.
Yeah, that Zoe 101, she had
in the show, she was pregnant.
Oh.
My life as a...
Oh, Secret Life of American Teenager.
Yes, Secret Life of American
Teenager.
Yes.
I watched that show, too.
Yes. We have one more last question. What is one goal that you... So you're in our major, so we know your major. We know the stereotype of your major. That's one question we were asking people. But what is one goal you have for yourself, either in school, like short-term or long-term?
Long-term, I would like to make music videos and produce music and maybe even short film one day.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. Oh, any short-term?
Short-term, so
girl. Why can't I say that? Short-term
goal. Okay.
Let me try to say it really fast. Short-term goals.
A short-term goal would probably just to graduate.
That's a good goal.
Mm-hmm. And
really?
Yeah. Oh, I forgot long-term, I want to own my own business.
Awesome. All right.
So
well,
pretty much, Emily's going to own her own business. And in that business, she's going to create a short film. She's going to produce music videos and she's going to make music. So this girl's a triple threat right here. That's what I'm hearing.
Well, maybe. We're not too sure yet.
Well, we would
like
never
give up on your dreams.
Yeah.
True. Mm-hmm.
That was awesome. All right. All right, guys, thank you for watching our show this week.
As you can see, we made a lot of people uncomfortable. We also made a lot of friends.
A lot
while
of friends.
We were interviewing everybody, finding out stereotypes about their majors and just funny things about them.
Yes, so this is what we do on a rainy day at Marywood, I guess. But no, we made awesome friends. Like, I'm going to go and get Moe's with Carson.
Annie's always going to be available to give us snacks and give us nutrition advice.
Yes, so we are ready to go.
We're rocking with it.
Yeah. I only have three friends, so now I have at least five.
Exactly. So we're building Erin's friend chain.
I love this show. Oh my God. Changing lives. You guys changed my world over here. Okay. Well, thank you guys for watching. Next week or in 2 weeks, we'll promise we will have a guest back to normal schedule.
So instead of being stuck with us for 10 to 15 minutes or however long it takes us to edit compared to 30.
Yes. So stay tuned for next week.
And forget, stay safe after dark.
Yeah.